Welcome back to the helpers, and today we're going to start off with trigonometry, the sine and the cos laws. Now, before we start off with the actual matter, I'd like you all to recall how to label the sides of a triangle. So I'm going to choose any one of the vertices, that's one of the corners. I've chosen this one, you can choose any you like, and I've started with labeling the first vertex A. I'm going to start moving anti-clockwise, so if the clock goes 1, 2, 3, I'm going to go anti-clockwise, so that's A, B, and C. Now that I've labeled my vertices, I'm going to start with labeling my sides. So I'm going to start off with A, and I'm going to go straight ahead to the side opposite to A. So I'm going to make a straight line. So this is the straight line, and this will be A meters or A centimeters, a length, okay? So this side will be labeled A. Then I'm going to go off to angle B. So from angle B, I'm going to draw a line straight to the side opposite to B, right? And that will be labeled a small b. B meters, B centimeters, B millimeters, whatever. Now, similarly, I'm going to go to C, angle C, and I'm going to go straight to the side opposite to C. And this will become a small c, right? So now I've labeled my triangle. Now let's see what we can do with this labeling, right? So my first law is the sine law. Now, how does the sine law work? I'll just give you the details. So it's a upon sine a equals b over sine b equals c over sine c. And you know how to label a, b, and c. So given the sample question, now let's see how we can solve this sample question using this formula and the method I've just taught you here. So over here, for the sine law to work, I need two things, actually three things. I need a pair of an angle and its opposite side. So for example, I need A and a capital A, or I need angle B and the side B, or I need angle C and the side C. And I also need just one other thing, another angle, another side, whatever. So in this case, we have a straight line, right? So we have 20 and 60 along this line. So I can apply the sine rule, okay? So the small a would obviously be a side, right? So in this case, the side is 60. Right, over the sine of the angle opposite to the side, because it's A over sine A. So A over sine A, so that's sine 20, equals, now B over here I could take 40. The small b is going to be a side and not an angle. So that's 40 upon sine, let's take this as x, okay? I didn't have to label the vertices in this case because it's unnecessary, but if you want to, you can. Right, so now let's look at how to solve it. So 60 upon sine 20 happens to be 175.428. Equals 40 upon sine x. Now if I try cross multiplying, the sine x goes up and this 175.428 comes down. So we have sine x is equal to 40 upon 175.428. Right, so let's do that. 40 upon 175.428 gives me 0.228, which means that sine x equals 0.228. Now in order to find x, what I must do is, if sine x is equal to this, then x is equal to sine inverse of 0.228. So let's go sine inverse of the answer, and that's 13.18. So x happens to be 13.18 degrees. So x is 13.18 degrees, and that's my answer. So this is how I use the sine rule to find find this answer for the angle x. And let's try something else. So now I've shifted the 40 to become 140 degrees for this example. So let's try solving this question. In this case, again, our ratio will stay the same. That's side A, which is 60, over sine, the sine of the angle that goes in the straight line. That's 20. You can always draw this straight line to find out which side is opposite to which angle. So this becomes B over sine B. Now, I have an angle, but I don't have the side. I don't have, let's call this B. So that's B over, I have the angle, that's sine 140. Okay? So I'm going to take sine 140 and multiply it with the 60. That becomes 60 sine 140 divided by sine of 20, which is, I'm calculating this as I go along, so B becomes 112.76, okay, and that is the length of the side B, okay. Another thing to remember, if it helps, is that the line opposite to the largest angle will obviously always be the longest line. So if this is 140 and this is 20, then the last side will also be 20 actually. But the point to be noticed is that B, which is opposite to the largest angle 140, will always be the longest side. So if angle B is large, then the side B will also be large, right? Just to be noticed. So we've done a case where we had an unknown angle that we had to find, and we've done a case where we had to find an unknown side B. I hope that makes things clear. Do post a comment if you have any further queries. Another thing that we need to know about the sine rule is that sine x equals 180 minus sine x. This is another rule for the sine ratio. So this means essentially that the sine of 30 will be equal to the sine of 180 minus 30, which is 150. Which means that if you have a straight line and you have an angle lying on that line, so the sine of this angle will be equal to the sine of this angle on both sides of this chord. Right? So we can try this out. So sine 30 happens to be 0.5, right? So sine 30 equals 0.5. And sine 180 minus 30, which is sine 150, also happens to be 0.5. You can try that out on your own calculators. This will work all the time. So where does this come in handy? It's when you have a triangle that is something like this. So this is a triangle I've drawn for reference. And let's see if we can apply the sine rule to this. So I start off at this angle and I make a straight line ahead. Now I have this angle and I have this side. So this means that I can apply the sine rule. So let's go ahead and apply it. So we have 7, the side, over sine 45 equals 9, let's draw this line here, 9 over sine x. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start by cross multiplying. So we have 9, or let's just take 7 upon sine 45, and that's 7 root 2, right? And then we go 9 upon 7 root 2 equals sine x. So 9 upon 7 root 2 equals 0.909. So sine x equals 0.909 something something. Okay? So x happens to be the sine inverse of this thing. And you you get 65.38. I'll round that off to 65.4 degrees. And you're really happy that, okay, I've got my answer. And like, we're done. But if you look at this question, this x happens to be an obtuse angle. So it cannot be less than 90 degrees. Obtuse angles are between 90 and 180. And obviously, if this is 90 degrees, then x is obviously bigger than that. So you need to be careful about this. So x will not be 65.4. It will actually be 180. This will be 65.4. And x will actually be 180 minus 65.4. And that is 114.6. So your actual value of x and the answer to my question is 114.6 degrees. So just be careful about this. Now when we move on to cosine rules, the simple rule of thumb is a squared equals b squared plus c squared minus 2bc cos a. You just need to memorize this formula. So when can this be applied? It's when you have this case satisfied. It's called SAS rule. Okay? So you have side, angle, side. Side, angle, side, side, angle, side. Okay? So over here I have a side, I have the angle in the middle, and I have another side. So I can apply the cosine rule. I cannot apply the sine rule because if I start from this angle and make a straight line ahead, I don't have this side here. So the sine rule is useless. So applying this cosine rule, I have a squared, that is this unknown side. Okay, so I have a squared equals b is 40 in this case plus 60 squared minus 2 into 40 into 60 into cos. I have the side, the angle opposite to this A, that is 20. And then I'm just going to put this entire thing into my calculator to get the value of A squared. Okay? So that happens to be 40 squared plus 60 squared minus 2 times 40 times 60 times cos 20, which gives me 689.5. Okay, now if a squared is this, then a equals under root this, right? I'm going to take square roots on both sides. Square root and square cancelled, a becomes the under root of this answer, which is a equals 26.3 meters or centimeters or whatever. Okay, so this way I've got the value of a using the cosine rule. Okay, so for this example, I've already done the working to make it faster. So this is another case where the cosine rule can be used. First of all, let's see whether the sine rule is useful or not. So I've drawn this line, and I have this side over here, but I don't have this angle. So the sine rule will be useless. So now let's look at the cosine rule. Now I don't have a side, an angle, and a side, but what I do have is three sides that are given to me. So like three sides. And that is another case where the cosine rule can be used. So using these values, I have a squared, 70 squared equals b squared plus c squared, 60 squared plus 40 squared, minus 2bc, 2 into 40 into 60, times cos x. And that becomes cos x equals 70 squared minus 60 squared minus 40 squared divided by minus 2 into 40 into 60, and x becomes 86.4 degrees, because that's cos inverse of all of this. So that's another way you can use the cosine rule. Another thing similar to this rule for sine is that cos x equals 180 minus cos x. So this means that cos 30 will be equal to cos 150. Okay, the usage will be similar to the usage for the sine rule, similar to this. So just memorize this. Feel free to ask if you have any questions, and thank you for watching.